License Plate Recognition, LPR, is a powerful add-on to Milestone VMS. It helps manage parking, prevents loss, regulates access, and assists in evidence gathering. In this video tutorial, you will learn how to get the best results with your LPR cameras. The camera is the first device in the chain. When it fails, the rest of the process fails. Proper camera selection and setup determine image quality. Remember, a good image for the human eye might not be a good image for the software. We also need to consider visibility of license plate, camera angle, lighting and weather, vehicle speed, size, and type, exposure, and image contrast. While you can use any camera, Milestone recommends infrared cameras because they work in virtually all conditions. We also recommend fixed lens cameras because autofocus makes software calibration difficult. Your field of view should not be much larger than a car width. Allow room for variance in lane position. If you need higher resolution, your FOV may be too wide. Capture only what you need. A stroke is the width of a line in a letter or number. Because the thickness of strokes depends on country and plate style, measurements like pixels per centimeter or pixels per inch are not used. The recommended resolution of the stroke thickness is 2.7 pixels per stroke, and the physical stroke thickness is 1 centimeter for a European plate and 0.27 inches for a US plate. For proper recognition in an image, US plates should be 130 pixels wide if the vehicle is stopped and 215 pixels wide if in motion. European plates should be 170 pixels wide if stopped, and 280 if in motion. Mount the camera so that you can draw a horizontal line that crosses both the left and right edge of the license plate in the captured images. Let's look at samples of correct and incorrect angles for recognition. LPR will not recognize the plate if the angle is too high. The vertical angle to the plate should not exceed 30 degrees. The horizontal angle to the plate should not exceed 25 degrees. It's important to consider lighting and weather. Because these conditions vary, we recommend infrared cameras. LPR works best with high contrast images, and IR will work at night, in rain, and in fog. Vehicle speed is another reason to have your camera aligned with the direction of travel. Plates that travel across the FOV will have more motion blur than plates coming toward or moving away from the camera. Camera exposure determines how light or dark and sharp or blurry an image appears when it has been captured. This is determined by three camera settings: aperture, shutter speed, and ISO speed. Understanding their uses and interdependency can help you to set up the camera correctly for LPR. Increasing the aperture, an adjustable hole through which light passes, allows more light to the sensor and reduces the depth of field. Reducing the aperture will allow less light to the sensor, but increases the depth of field. It can be counterintuitive because as the f-stop decreases, the area of the opening increases. The shutter speed is the duration of the exposure. Increasing it allows more light, but can introduce motion blur. ISO speed is the sensitivity of the camera's sensor to a given amount of light. Increasing the ISO speed will increase gain or brightness. However, in order to do so, it introduces image noise. Also, consider the range of vehicle sizes and types you expect to observe. To determine the right contrast for your LPR camera, consider the difference in gray value between the license plate's characters and the license plate's background color. Pixels can have value ranges from 0 to 255. When you convert your input image to grayscale image, the minimum pixel value difference between a pixel in the text and a pixel in the background should be at least 15. Let's look at some examples. Finally, make sure these functions are turned off in your camera. Gain is a way to brighten the image, but it adds image noise. Milestone recommends you set gain as low as possible or disable it. Automatic enhancement. Some cameras use contouring, edge, or contrast enhancement to make them look better to people. Such effects interfere with the LPR algorithms. And automatic compression. High compression rates degrade the quality of the image. If you use JPEG compression, keep the quality at 80% or better. You just saw how to get the best results with your LPR cameras. Visit our YouTube site to view other tutorials in this playlist.